Before we start the journey of unchanged thoughts and several ideas, I'd like to ask you a few questions. What do you think governs our actions? What do you think is responsible to make us do the impossible things that we think they are? And most importantly, dear August gathering, ponder upon this question critically. What do you think makes us change? By the way, when you ponder upon it, I'd like to introduce myself. I am Rebecca John, an 11th class grader. And today I'm here to talk about a very important topic, that's sustainable development. Now, I asked you a question that what makes us change? Now, there are many factors contributing to it, like society, surroundings, etc. But we humans are resilient. We are resistant to change. And we only resort to change when we want it. I emphasize when we want it. A good example for this is that when I was in grade 9, I neglected my studies because of extracurricular activities and my report card was a total form of disappointment, which I think a lot of people can relate to. It was sad. So I decided to change my thoughts from I can't multitask to I can multitask. And that was all there is to it. That was my first step and that changed my life. It made me who I am. It made me a confident person. And this first step is the hardest to take. Now, if you are a procrastinator like me, perception is a weapon you need. And we all now need to change our approach and our perception towards attaining a sustainable future. Why? Because for this, I'd like to quote the UNESCO Asia Progress Report of 2018 and 19, which clearly states that we are lagging far behind to catch up on the 17 SDG goals given to us by UN with our current pace. We won't be achieving it by 2030. We might not even achieve it by 2050 if we are going by our current pace. This is a graph that shows the reality. This graph shows us that we are not even up to the benchmark. We are not even up to the benchmark of 2018. We are even decelerating in some cases. We are truly lacking the importance, the sense of importance we are supposed to give to this topic. This is the status of where we are today. And we have to pace up. We have to grow at an exponential rate to stop our downfall. Now, this brings me to my next set of questions. That is, how much do you think we invest in industrialization? Well, for India alone, we invest in around $93.8 billion. So, my dear audience, this is a random question. What do you think we invest for the waiting to be renewed environment or for sustainable development in countries, for example? That contains everything. That contains stuff starting from infrastructure till sustainable energy. Any guesses? None? Okay. So we invest around less than one third of what we invest in industrialization. In grade 7th, I came across the word sustainable development for the first time. Now before that, I used to think it was just environment saving thing and something like that, global warming issues. Apparently it was not so. It included everything. It included stuff from non-poverty to hunger strikes, to everything, a holistic development. Creating a balance between industrial revolution and environmental causes. That will give us the future we desire for the future generations to come, as well as for us to reserve the resources for the same without harming the environment. The true definition of sustainable development. Now, I had this competition called Bal Vigyan for 6 years straight, okay? There were many topics I'd taken up during this time, like plastic to fuel, CO2 to fuel, biophilic city, zero waste city, all of this. And believe it or not, this competition had many young minds giving brilliant ideas, but none of them were considered as important to even be pondered upon, to be even mused upon by the higher authorities. We were required to go and ask the liability of our project to different people of the same background so that we come to realize how we found how we form business proposals. Well, I'll show you. I went to a lot of fire authorities. They were all impressed by the projects. They were like, yes, our city can become a sustainably developed city. However, that was all there is to it. They did not go for further investigation. They promised they did not. Well, that's how things are. That is how insignificantly we neglect our responsibility towards sustainability and towards our future generation, while claiming that we are investing in industrialization. Well, I'm not targeting anything. I just like to tell you that sustainable development is something that will make us attain global peace. For democracy, it is very important. Why? Because it empowers citizens. Now, one of the major priorities of the SDG goals is that countries should engage and empower citizens to take part in fulfilling all of these goals. And that is what the countries are looking forward to. We have taken steps. Now we need to take a leap. Now, in my city, we were a bit lax towards our attitude towards everything regarding sustainable development, but then started Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, with which we paced up a bit. That is when we changed our perception. That is when we started to work, and that is when we cleaned our city. Now, for all of you, you might think that this is such a small achievement, this should be the basic necessity. It was not for us. It was a big achievement for us. Why? Because we achieved one of the major SDG goals, that is sanitation, with this. Now, sustainable development is something that should come with us as stakeholders of this planet. It is not our property to destroy. I would say that I would play my part as an empowered citizen to do everything in my power to change the perception of those around me and myself to participate and partake in activities that will promote sustainable development. And I will become, and I will ask the people to become stakeholders for environment. That will be me filling my duty towards my country. That is what I'd like to say, and I'd like to end my speech with a message to the 6 billion people out there. Out of the 7.7 billion people who just listened, do you know that 4 billion people don't even have the awareness tools that you have? They don't even have the basic necessities? Do you know that 63.8% of the people of this world are still not aware of any SDGs goals that are there? Do you know that when I performed a questionnaire just in my city of 500 people, I came to know that none of them, even adults, didn't know the meaning of sustainable development. That is how the bad situation is. We need to buck up, change things, change our perception, and do now. Because we have had enough talks. We have had enough movies, shows for decades for awareness. Now it's time for us to take action. For all of you who just listen, this is my message to you. The wounds that the nature that are ignored now, then what will happen is your wounds will not get any herbs to heal. Let us not wait till we perish. Let us do something. Thank you.